Hello, and welcome to my channel Happy Learning to You, your ultimate guide to easy learning. Today, let's continue with genetics, and the topic under this are principles of inheritance and variation. And today, I'm going to introduce you to Mendel's law of inheritance. Now, as I mentioned in my previous video, you can have the link on top. Gregor Mendel was a person who introduced this law of inheritance by conducting hybridization experiments on garden peas for 7 years. And ultimately, he proposed this law of inheritance in living organisms. Now, in his experiments, he investigated those characters in garden pea plants that were manifested as two opposing traits by conducting artificial cross-pollination experiments using several true breeding pea lines. Now let's look at what do you mean by traits. So traits are nothing but characteristics which are caused by genetics. So whatever characteristics we exhibit, like the shape of the face, hair color, skin color, these are characteristics. Next is, what is cross-pollination? Now, first let me tell you what is pollination. Pollination is a process by which pollen is transferred from male reproductive organ to the female reproductive organ. Now, when this transfer occurs between two different plants, it is known as cross-pollination. Okay, and the next definition is, what is artificial pollination? Now, as you know, pollination is a natural process. But when, for the purpose of experiment, do this transfer manually, it becomes artificial pollination. Now, the definition of true breeding. Now, what are true breeding pea lines? A line that has undergone several self-pollination and shows stable trait inheritance and expression for several generations. Okay, so let me tell you what is self-pollination. So again, pollination, as you know, is a transfer of pollen from the male reproductive organ to the female reproductive organ. Now, when this transfer occurs within the same flower or a different flower of the same plant, it is known as self-pollination because it is within the same plant. Okay, so now, again, I'll explain you the experiment which I've mentioned in the previous slide in terms of the definitions. So, his hybridization experiments investigated those characters in the garden pea plants which were manifested as two opposite characteristics. Okay, by conducting artificial pollination, that is by manually transferring pollens from the male reproductive organ of one plant to the female reproductive organ of the other plant using a line that has undergone several self-pollination and shows stable inheritance of the traits. Okay. Now, next. Now, to carry out this hybridization experiment, he had used 7 pairs of contrasting traits in these pea plants. So, what do you mean? 7 pairs meaning 14 true breeding pea plants. So, total 14 in pairs, which were similar to each other except for one character with contrasting traits. Okay, so there was one character in these pairs which was differing and all other characteristics were same. So he selected in such a way. So the characters and the opposing traits. One trait is dominant and the other is recessive. I'll explain you after some time. What do you mean by dominant and recessive? So coming back to the 7 pairs of contrasting traits which Mendel studied, these were the characters. The seed shape, seed color, flower color, pod shape, pod color, flower position, and the stem height. So these are the 7 characteristics that he studied. Traits were the seed shape round, seed color yellow, flower color violet, pod shape full, pod color green, flower position axial, and stem height is tall. So these were the 7 traits, and the opposing traits for this were wrinkle sheet seed shape, a green seed color, white flower color, constricted pod, yellow pod color, terminal flower position, and dwarf stem height. So these traits were just opposite of each other, contrasting traits. Okay, so this 7, so total he studied 14 pea plants. Okay, so what is a dominant trait now? Now, a trait, so it is a character which will be seen in the offspring if contributed by one of the parents. It dominates, this trait dominates the other trait, and therefore it is known as a dominant, as the word suggests. And a recessive trait is the character which is carried in the genes without appearing in the offspring. So this character, so these recessive traits, these 7 traits are present in the genes, but they are not expressed. So this is all I have under the Mendel's law of inheritance. So today I have just explained you about the basics about the hybridization experiment and what he used. So basically he conducted hybridization experiments on garden pea plants using 7 pairs of contrasting traits. So that was total 14 pea plants that were true breeding. My next video will include details about the inheritance of one gene. Under these, I will tell you about the experiment what he conducted, what were his observations and inferences. So do keep watching this space for more details and more videos on genetics and the principles of inheritance and variation. Thanks for watching and would love to receive your valuable feedback. Subscribe to my channel.